Hey friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. This video is based on one Neumann architecture. So here I'll explain you how one Neumann architecture is there with computer system. So before you see how one Neumann architecture is there, you should have some basic understanding related how programs and datas are there with memory. So obviously inside memory we store programs as well as data. So first of all, you should know the basic difference in between what is program and what is data. Let me give you some examples. Like for example, when you have any MP3 song, so that MP3 song, that is a data that you will be playing inside program, which is MP3 player. So MP3 player, that is a program that will execute this data, right? For example, you have video file. So video file, that is a data that you will be playing inside any video player. So that video player, that is a program. So here what we do is, here when CPU is executing program, at that time it is executing instructions of program, along with that it will be accessing data. And here it is not only about, it is only reading data from the memory. Sometimes it may write the data as well. Let me give you one more example. Like, for example, you have one PPT. So that PPT is a data that you will be opening inside a program, which is Microsoft PowerPoint program. So what will happen when you double click on PPT? You will be opening this data inside a program, and that program is Microsoft PowerPoint. When you open this, at that time you can read the program, as well as here you can modify the data as well. So whenever you edit the PPT, what will happen? That data will change. With video and with audio, we don't change data, but there are some data which may need to changed. So here CPU, that will be executing programs, along with that it will be accessing data. So when it accesses the data, at that time it may read the data as well as it may write the data. So inside memory we store data as well as program, and as if CPU is accessing memory, which is having data as well as program in the same memory, then you can say this architecture is one Neumann architecture. Let us see all those things step by step. So here when we talk about one Neumann architecture, then you should know, here we have memory which is having program as well as data, and here with same memory we have program and data, and by same system bus we access program as well as data with CPU. That's why this architecture is referred as one Neumann architecture. So main memory is having program as well as data, and that is been accessed by common system bus, right? So at the same time you cannot have program execution as well as data access, right? Either you have program instruction over here on this system bus, or you may have data access, right? As we have common buses over here to access this main memory. So one Neumann architecture that is having main memory, which will be having program and data in the same memory, right? So by giving command by input, you can execute any program, right? But at the same time, you cannot execute instructions of program, and you cannot execute data at the same time along with program, right? That's why you can say one Neumann architecture is bit slower. Here with CPU, as we know, it is having control unit, resistors and ALU. This control unit is controlling everything. It controls this system bus, it controls internal operation of this CPU, right? This arithmetic and logic unit, that we have it to execute instructions. By input devices we give command, and by output devices we see our output. Let me give you a few more examples. Like when we write any program in higher level language, at that time inside program you will be having instructions as well as data. So you can consider program executes instructions, and data that is also there in main memory, right? So in this same program, you see we have data as well as instruction. Like when you write int, a is equals to 8, b is equals to 5, and c, then here you are defining integers where a and b, that is having fixed values, right? And c is variable. And after that, you see what we are writing is c is equals to b plus a. So this is instruction which is there based on addition, and these are finite data, right? So here with main memory, you'll be having this data as well as this type of instructions. So when you want to execute any program, at that time you will be executing instructions along with data which is there inside common memory. So when compiler is compiling this program, it will be generating binary data, and that is there with program as well as data, right? So program means sets of instructions, along with that data will be there, and program and data both are stored in a common memory over here with one Neumann architecture. So here, my dear students, when we talk about main memory of one Neumann architecture, then it consists program as well as data in the same memory over here. So common system bus that is there for accessing program as well as data. Here, when we talk about control unit, then you should know this control unit is providing timing control, instruction fetch, instruction decode, pipelining, memory access. So everything is been controlled by this control unit along with CPU. Here, resistors are there to operate with this CPU. So those resistors are having very small amount of memory, and that could be operand of this ALU. By using these resistors, ALU performs all the arithmetic and logical operations. There can be many resistors inside CPU, like general purpose resistors, flag resistors, stack resistor, program counter. In future coming videos, I'll be explaining you general purpose computer along with its resistor organization, so that you can have more clarity about how resistors are there. Right now, consider these resistors are used to execute programs, and that could be operand of ALU, and we are executing programs inside CPU with the use of these resistors only, right? Here, when we talk about ALU, then it performs all the arithmetic and logical operation. Like you can perform multiplication, division, addition, subtraction, right? You can perform all the logical operations as well as like AND, logic OR, logic XOR, logic NOT. So all those things that is been performed by ALU. Here, when we talk about IO devices, then you should know to give input command, we use input devices. Like you can have mouse, keyboard, as well as output devices are used to see how output is coming. Like you can have monitor, you can have printer, you can have speaker, right? So based on your output, you can interface any number of output devices with CPU to see how output is coming. So basically, when we talk about one Neumann architecture, then you should know when you store program and data, that will be stored inside a common memory. That is how things are there. When program and data both are stored in a separate memory, that architecture is Harvard architecture, right? But this one Neumann architecture, that is cheap in terms of cost, and you can observe initial version of microprocessor with Intel like 8085, 8086. So that is having this architecture only, like it was having one Neumann architecture only, right? It was not having separate memory for program and data. So this is how all those things are there. I hope it is clear to you. Still, if any confusion is there, just post that in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.